स्लाइड दिख रहा है?
यस सर।
ओके, so let us discuss about the structure of carbene, right? मैं साथ में इन लोगों को इन भी कर रहा हूं. यू सी दैट, आवाज आ रही ना मेरी?
यस सर.
हाँ, कुछ भी हो तुरंत बताइएगा मुझे. तो स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कार्बिन, यस्टरडे आई इनिशिएटेड समथिंग लाइक रिगार्डिंग द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कार्बिन. So as I told that it has only 6 electrons, so generally it is electron deficient. So if you see the structure, there are two theories about the structure of carbene. It may be either have linear structure with sp hybridization, or it may have bent structure with sp2 hybridization, right? So now see this one, the tools. If you see this structure, this is the SPS hybridization structure in which there is the arrangement of the 6 electron. The 2s sigma electrons, p, sigma electron, it is combining with the SPS hybridization. With the SPS hybridization, two hydrogens are connected with this carbon with sp2s hybridization, while the p electron contains the electron pair, remaining two electron in different p orbitals to avoid mutual interactions. Because of interactions, they are going to create high energy structure. It has been assumed that the structure of carbene is analogous to that of alkyne with sp hybridization to accommodate 6 electron with an angle of 180 degree. If you consider the energy in terms of energy, this structure has more energy due to 2 p orbitals, which is of more energy level, right? So that has one proposal, if carbene may have sp hybridization and it is analogous to the alkyne, but with 180 degree angle. But because of the, as far as energy constraint is concerned, they have more energy, so little bit less energy in this. Experimentally, it has been found that most of carbene has bent structure. Most of carbene has bent structure with angle around 100 to 150 degree. With angle around 100 to 150 degree. It means they have sp2 hybridization with trigonal planar structure, and sp2 hybrid carbene would have three low energy sp2 hybrid orbitals and one high energy p orbital to accommodate 6 electrons. This may be possible with two arrangements of the carbene structure. Now discuss about the first structure. Total number of orbitals are same in both the structure to accommodate the 6 electrons. Now see this one. This is the sp2 hybrid carbon. Electrons are unpaired in this arrangement. There is a one electron in the p orbital and there is a one electron in the sp2 orbital, right? So sp2 orbital contains one electron and p orbital contains one electron, right? So sp2 hybrid, what it is of low energy, and p orbital is what it is of high energy. It is of high energy, right? That means there this distribution in which there is a one electron in the p orbital and one electron in the sp2 orbitals. So they are what? They are unpaired. These two electrons are what? They are unpaired. They are present in the different orbitals. They are present in the different orbitals. And out of two electrons, one in the sp2 hybrid orbital, that is the non-bonding electron, this orbital is of low energy. This orbital is of low energy. Since it has two electrons in different orbitals, it will behave as a biradical. It is going to behave as a biradical. And it is, in terms of magnetic field, it is a paramagnetic in nature. It is paramagnetic in nature. So the structure in which the two electrons are residing on the different orbitals, such a structure is referred as triplet structure. This is the structure of a triplet carbene. Now let us see the structure of the singlet carbene. Singlet carbene, it has p orbital and it has sp2 low energy orbital, right? Now the p orbital, which is of high energy, it is vacant, but in the sp2 orbital, both the electrons are present and they are paired. So the according to the magnetic nature, it is going to be the diamagnetic in nature, right? And since it is paired one, it is present in a single orbital, which is of sp2 hybrid carbon, orbital of the sp2 hybrid carbon, okay? So they are also referred as non-bonding electron, but since they are paired, then it is referred as a singlet carbene, right? So now let us more discussion about the structure of carbene. So in which the both electrons are paired, it is referred as in which the electrons are present in two different orbitals. That means electrons are unpaired. They are referred as triplet carbene. It is going to behave as a radical, and this is triplet is going to behave as a paramagnetic in nature, radical as well as paramagnetic in nature. While singlet one is going to be paired electron, and it is of diamagnetic in nature, right? Now, in terms of bond angle and energy, let us discuss about this structure of the triplet carbene. It has one electron in the p orbital and one electron in the sp2 orbital. So, low energy sp2 orbital has one electron. It will create less repulsion. Orbital are almost degenerate. Half field है ना, दोनों में एक इलेक्ट्रॉन है तो डी जनरेट. सो द एंगल इज गोइंग टू बी अराउंड 130 टू 150 डिग्री. एंड ओवरऑल एनर्जी ऑफ ट्रिपलेट कार्बीन इज रिलेटिवली लेस देन द एनर्जी ऑफ द सिंगलेट कार्बीन. यू सी इफ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस इज सिंगलेट कार्बीन, दिस इज द ऑफ ट्रिपलेट कार्बीन, दिस इज स्ट्रक्चर इज ऑफ द ट्रिपलेट कार्बीन. And this structure is of the singlet carbene. Okay? Now see this one. It has two electrons in the sp2 hybrid orbital, right? And the p orbital is vacant. All the six electrons are paired and in low energy sp2 hybrid orbital. High energy p orbital is empty, but repulsion of paired sp2 hybrid orbital electron are more than the repulsion generated by one sp2 electron which is present in the triplet carbene. Here is only one electron, here are two electrons. So the repulsion, this repulsion which is generated by the singlet carbene, it is going to be more than the repulsion which is created by the presence of only one electron in the sp2 hybrid orbital, right? So the angle is going to be what? Because this angle, we are talking about this angle. So see, it is creating more repulsion. So that bond is going to be shorter one. So it is going to be around 100 to 110 degree. While in case of triplet carbene, since this repulsion is more, so this angle is wider. This angle is wider. That's why this angle is around 130 to 150 degree. Okay? So this is the structure of the triplet. Triplet carbene is more stable because it has repulsion of only one non-bonded electron, while singlet carbene has more repulsion due to two non-bonding electrons. Also, in terms of energy, energy gain to bring p orbital electron into sp2 hybrid orbital is less to overcome the repulsion created by the two electron in the sp2 hybrid orbitals. Right? Now, these are the some examples of the triplet carbene. This is methylene carbene, alkyl methylene carbene, phenyl ethylene carbene, phenyl alkyl substituted carbene. And these are the singlet carbenes like dichlorocarbene, chloromethylcarbene, methoxymethylcarbene. These are all examples of the singlet carbene. So overall energy, if you talk about the stability factor, since the energy, overall energy of triplet carbene is more than that of the singlet carbene, therefore triplet carbene is supposed to be more stable than the singlet carbene, right? Carbene that have singlet ground state, okay? Carbene that has singlet ground state like dichlorocarbene have two electron rich substituents of Cl atom in form of lone pair of electron adjacent to the carbon center. Is carbon center ke paas do Cl atom hai na, do chloride laga hua hai, and Cl also have pair of electrons, lone pair of electrons. So that has been written, two electron rich substituent in the form of lone pair of electron adjacent to carbon center. Thus pair of electron interacts with p orbital of carbene to produce a new low energy orbital which occupy two electron. It means what? This stabilization of pair of electron encourage the electron of p orbital to pair in sp2 hybrid orbital. That is why dichlorocarbene or chloro substituted carbene type of carbene in the ground state remains in the singlet state. Some may ask the question why dichlorocarbene remains in the singlet state. So that is the reason, because of the interaction of the extra lone pair of electron present on the chlorine atom with the p orbital of the carbene, of the carbon of the this center carbon of the carbene, that makes overall energy of the system is lower. Okay, na? So that is the stabilization of the pair of electron to electron encourage the electron of p orbital to pair sp2 hybrid orbital of the carbon. That's why the dichlorocarbene remains singlet in the ground state. Some carbene having electron donating substituents are less electrophilic than the other carbene, like diaminocarbene are quite nucleophilic in nature. ठीक है ना? So because as we in general क्या होता है carbene क्या is voice आ रहा है ना proper? In general, carbene is electron deficient. It behaves as a electrophile. Okay, but there are some examples in which carbene can also behave as a nucleophilic in nature. It behaves as a nucleophile in nature, as for example of diamino carbene. Right. Something more about this carbene, if we want. You see that. Regarding the structure of carbene from this content, same thing has been also. Okay, na? This is the structure of the considering the bent structure. The two electrons in the sp2 hybrid orbital with 120 degree angle. That is sp2 hybridization. That is the structure of the singlet carbene, right? And another one in which the two electrons are present in two different orbitals, one in the p, one in the sp. Sp hybrid orbital of the carbon, then it is going to be the singlet carbene. So this is the structure for considering the bent structure, and this is for considering the linear structure. अगर आप इसको linear structure का अगर इसको adopt कर रही है, तो ये structure adopt करेगा या ये bent structure में. Same thing, same argument has been given for the triplet carbene also, right? This is the comparison of the different two electronic states of the carbene that I will transfer to all of you. So further read, पढ़ने के लिए है आपके लिए, ठीक है ना? So this is the lowest H singlet state. Lowest singlet state में सभी आपकी photochemistry पढ़ेंगे तो वहाँ पे discuss और करेंगे singlet triplet के बारे में. The ground state में क्या होता है? Electrons are paired, so that is referred as the singlet state. But in the excited state, what will happen? These two electron in the different excited different states, one in the ground state and another one in the upper excited state, but still they are paired. You see the spin, they are inverted to each other, okay, na, anti-parallel to each other. So still they are paired. But there is another state in which after the excitation of electron from the ground state goes, if it goes into the upper excited state, there is a spin inversion. You see the spin is changed, okay, na? They are parallel to each other. So now this is going to create another state. In the state in which the two different states are created with the excitation of electron, that is in which the electron spin is not paired, it is now going to be unpaired one, then that state is referred as triplet states, right? Now these are the some things about the reactions that I have discussed yesterday also. So same reactions has been discussed about the stereoselective and stereospecific reactions. ये सारे reactions हैं उसके carbenes के, ठीक है? So you may further prepare your notes with the help of this study material. Different kind of carbenes का reaction है, वो सारे आप notes अपना बना लीजिएगा. मैं अभी ये topic जब खत्म होगा, तो I will transfer all this content to all of you, right? Now moving to towards the structure of one of the another intermediate is nitrene. You see the structure of nitrene. The structure of nitrene, this is the structure of nitrene, right? Nitrene and carbene almost both have similar structure, but unlike carbene, in both the electronic state, nitrogen is what? sp hybridized. वहां पे कार्बिन में आपने क्या कंसीडर किया था कि अगर उसका कार्बिन का लीनियर स्ट्रक्चर है तो वो एसपी हाइब्रिडाइज्ड है, बट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इट हैज प्लैनर स्ट्रक्चर बिकॉज ऑफ द लो एनर्जी स्ट्रक्चर. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द प्लैनरिटी कार्बिन इज गेटिंग sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन, बट इन केस ऑफ नाइट्रीन व्हाट विल हैपन, इट इज स्टेट नाइट्रोजन इज एसपी हाइब्रिडाइज्ड. इन सिंगलेट स्टेट देयर आर टू पेयर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. इन द सिंगलेट स्टेट देयर आर two pairs of electron. Nitrogen ka jo pair of electron hai, pairs of electron, one pair in the sp hybrid orbital and other one in the p orbital. This is the p orbital which is occupied, which is fully occupied. So one p orbital in the singlet state remains vacant. This is the another p orbital that is the vacant, right? So in triplet state, one electron pair is in sp hybrid orbital. This is the structure of the singlet carbene, okay? And this is the structure of the excited singlet carbene. What will happen when we excite the singlet carbene? What will happen? This paired p electron, p orbital electron, it jumps into the another p orbital, right? This is the, now it is going to be half filled, right? It is again going to be half filled, but still you see their spins are paired. Their spins are, yeah, the single electrons have opposite spin, so it's still it is singlet structure. Now on the other hand, if you see the structure of the triplet nitrene, right, with the jump of the electron, what will happen? You see this electron in the singlet state is paired one, but here in the case of the nitrene, this spin inversion takes place. This p orbital still contains two electrons, that is they are degenerate half fill orbitals, right? But their spins are unpaired, single electrons having parallel spin. So that's why this is going to be a triplet state. So in triplet state, what will happen? One electron pair is in sp orbital and two p orbitals remain half filled, having electrons in parallel spin. So triplet nitrene is more stable and represents the ground state electronic configuration of a nitrene. That has been confirmed with the help of ESR spectroscopic technique. Like excited singlet of carbene, singlet nitrene can also exist as a excited singlet. ठीक है? Like carbenes, singlet nitrene reacts stereospecifically with olefinic compound in a concerted manner, and triplet nitrene reacts stereoselectively through open chain biradical formations. ठीक है ना? So these are the examples. Further example reactions of the nitrenes, and for that some typical examples I am showing from my study material. You see, this is the free radical. You see, these are the some reactions. Carbene, nitrene is also reactive, and it is very very reactive that it is difficult to isolate, but it can be trapped with the help of some, like for example, phenyl azo compound, chicken azine type of compound, on heating it is going to form a phenyl nitrene. If you treat this सिस्टम विद कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड अगर गैस वहां पे आप इंट्रोड्यूस कर दो, इट इज गोइंग टू बी आइसोलेटेड एज साइनेट, राइट? ठीक है, साइनेट, देन दैट मींस फॉर्मेशन ऑफ, यानी कि ओवरऑल व्हाट विद द हीटिंग इट इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म नाइट्रीन, देन इट रिएक्ट्स विद कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड टू फॉर्म द आइसोसाइनेट. दिस इंस्टेड ऑफ फेनिल, इफ यू हैव सिंपल HN, then it's going to react with the alkene molecule to form this kind of azerine system, cyclopropane ring system. Insertion reaction, as in case of the carbene, this nitrene also show insertion reactions to form the cyclic products. It is going to form the tricyclic compound with secondary amine in the middle of the ring. Addition to carbon-carbon double bond is stereospecific with singlet carbene, while it is non-stereospecific with the triplet carbene, as I said earlier. Similarly, the acyl nitrene or sulfonyl nitrene, undergo insertion reaction to form the amides, right? Like this is the acyl nitrene on reaction with the triethane. It is the simple aliphatic compound. It leads to the formation of your amide product. Insertion into CH single bond ring closure system, like this kind of system. This is the example of your sulfonyl nitrene, which is going to form during the course of reaction, and it leads to the formation of this bicyclic product. Aromatic nitrene also undergo dimerization to form the azo compound. Hydrogen abstraction reaction, either from the alpha to the nitrogen atom, or from fourth or fifth position to the nitrogen atom. From here, I may take one hydrogen from this alpha position, or 1, 2, 3, 4th position. Fourth position, or if it is more longer chain, then maybe fifth position. So it may abstract hydrogen. Hydrogen abstraction may take place, leading to the formation of enene type of product. CH double bond NH is going to form. Or if it is taking hydrogen from the fifth position, then it may undergo cyclization reaction. This is the example of the 1, 2. यहाँ से हाइड्रोजन निकला, और यहाँ क्या क्रिएट हुआ? CH double bond NH, right? Nitrogen क्या हुआ? Nitrogen gas as a निकल गया, right? Nitrogen as a gas निकल गया, और एक हाइड्रोजन नाइट्रोजन पे अटैच हुआ, तो CH double bond NH. When it is taking from this 1, 2, 3, 4th position, so again nitrogen is going to be eliminated, leading to the formation of a cyclic system that is called the pyrolidines. ठीक है, सुनाई पड़ रहा है ना आप लोगों को? एनी वन ऑफ यू? सुनाई पड़ रहा है ना ज्योति कुमारी? Shanu. सब क्लास ऑन कर सकते हेलो आयशा हाँ सुनाई पड़ रहा ना बेटा
सर
हाँ ठीक है नाउ मोर रिएक्शंस अबाउट द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ दिस नाइट्रीन्स फ्रॉम एजाइड दिस इज अ एग्जांपल ऑफ एजाइड RN3 ऑन फोटोलिसिस और थर्मोलिसिस इट इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट एल्किल नाइट्रीन सिंपल एसिल एजाइड ऑन फोटो रिएक्शन इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म द एसिल नाइट्रीन From isocyanate on photo irradiation is going to form the alkyl nitrene. So these are the some reactions from isocyanate like isothiocyanate. It is also on thermolysis in the gas phase leading to the formation of phenyl nitrene. Right. Similarly, a typical compound 2-benzene sulfonoxycarbamate under the alkaline condition, it is also going to form the carbamate. Nitrene, right? This is the nitro compound. This on reaction with the triethoxyphosphine, first form nitrosyl compound that releases further to form the phenyl nitrene. ठीक है ना? So these are the some reactions, important reactions that I have noted from these books for your information. And this is the book from where you can further note down all kinds of reactions like additional reactions concerted manner going to take place to form this kind of systems like the system acidine type of system so one is going to be the stereo specific product when it is going to take place via the singlet nitrene and when it is going to be the triplet nitrene it is going to be the stereo selective addition that means both cis trans isomers is going to form these are the some important reactions sara main nahi bata raha hu similarly if you take benzene and ethoxy carbonyl nitrene reaction with the benzene and nitrene which is the ethoxy carbonyl nitrene then it leads to the formation of a first bicyclic compound azylidine derivative then ring there is a further ring opening and it leads to the formation of a 7-membered ring compound that is called the azepine derivative so that is the ring expansion reaction involving the nitrene as an intermediate as in case of carbene insertion reaction aap padha hai usi tarah similarly there is the insertion reaction of nitrene with the aliphatic compound like alkane compound you can add the first via this transition state it leads to the formation of your CnHr product so this is the insertion reaction with the singlet nitrene right But in case of triplet nitrene, it leads this reaction is going by the formation of radical. This is the formation of bias three-membered azylene type of. जैसे वहाँ पे oxidane बनता था वहाँ पे azylene type of transition state. But here in case of the triplet carbene, it is going to first form radical, then it connects to form the final product. So this is the non-concerted inserted mechanism involving the triplet carbene because it is involving the formation of free radical first then their connection to form the product forget about this reaction this is the formation of carbazole from the nitrene you see if you have a nitrene in a biphenyl type of compound then it will undergo insertion reactions to form the carbazole type of derivative as I said there is a hydrogen abstraction reaction already discussed So in that case, this is the insertion reaction that is from the alpha, beta, gamma, delta, and this is a nitrene, and that carbon is alpha. If there is a alpha insertion, then what will happen? This hydrogen will come onto this nitrogen, which is going to form double bond NH. ठीक है ना? Imine derivative. Imine upon hydrolysis, imine का अगर water में hydrolysis कर दीजिए, तो that is going to form your aldehydic compound when it is from this alpha beta gamma delta position so you see one involvement of 1 2 3 4 5 atoms so that leads to the formation of a 5-membered ring methyl substituted ठीक है 5-membered ring so this is the alpha gamma insertion reaction you can also say or you can say there is abstraction of hydrogen from either from the alpha position or from the delta position a common reaction that is very well known common reaction hai that aapke course mein hai that is the Curtius reaction, out of four, Hoffman, Curtius, Lawson and Schmidt. So aapko padhna hai Curtius reaction. Curtius reaction, there is a intermediate acyl nitrene. Acyl nitrene undergo rearrangement reactions to form the isocyanate, and isocyanate upon hydrolysis with water molecule it leads to the formation of amine. Ye hum log baad mein abhi detail mein padhenge reactions ko. Theek hai? So this is overall about your reaction intermediates. I have the tried to give you the content regarding the different kinds of free radicals, carbocations, carbenions, free radicals, nitrenes and carbenes. Now it is now your responsibility to prepare a good notes of your all intermediates. Aapko uska notes acche se banana hai. और ये सारा जितना स्टडी मटेरियल है वॉट एवर आई हैव थॉट विद माय ओन नोट्स जो मैंने अपने नोट्स से बनाया भेजा है और जो बुक का कंटेंट है वो दोनों ही मैं आपके सारे ईमेल मैं अभी ले लूंगा आप लोगों का ईमेल और उस ईमेल से सारा ट्रांसफर कर दूंगा ठीक है सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर इंटरमीडिएट्स एंड नाउ बेस्ड ऑन योर इंटरमीडिएट्स यू हैव डिफरेंट some typical reactions which reactions aap logon ko padhni hai usme kon kon si reactions hai ye visible hai aapko some name reactions like Berkeley reaction Mitsunobu reaction dienol phenol rearrangement Wittig reaction benzidine rearrangement michael addition aur robinson addition kya hai ye aapka this is based on the कार्बेनायन ठीक है कार्बेनायन बेस्ड रिएक्शन है बर्कले रिएक्शन क्या है ये फ्री रेडिकल रिएक्शन है राइट विटिग रिएक्शन दिस इज आल्सो ए काइंड ऑफ कार्बेनायन टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन है फास्फोरस एलिड बनेगा नेगेटिव डिस्चार्ज कार्बेनायन टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन है वुल्फ रिएक्शन दैट इन्वॉल्व्स फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एसिल कार्बीन कर्टियस रिएक्शन दैट इन्वॉल्व्स द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एसिल नाइट्रीन Baer-Wilger oxidation. This is a kind of oxidation reaction in which the migration of group from carbon to electron deposition oxygen takes place. Okay. And another important, most important reaction is the Pinnacle-Pinnaculone rearrangement that involves a different kind of carbocations. Primary, secondary, tertiary carbocations are going to involve in this kind of reactions. So, ये आपको name reactions है that we will discuss. One by one. Let us start. Reaction intermediates. Reaction mechanisms. This content is visible. दिख रहा है? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Right. So this is the overall syllabus of your. That is the reaction intermediate content complete है. फिर एक topic आपका photochemistry है. And then this is the name reaction. ठीक है ना? So in this Berkeley reaction, Mitsunobu, dienol, phenol, Wittig, Michael, Robinson, Pinnacle, benzidine, Wolf, Curtius, and Baer-Wilger oxidation reactions. ठीक है तो ये first example that is the example of the इसको चाहे Brick reduction बोलिए या Birch reduction बोलिए कुछ भी बोलिए. The reaction is This reaction is run in liquid ammonia with an alkali metal and alcohol like ethanol and butanol. Two examples. This is the methoxy substituted benzene that it has, and that one is benzoic acid, yani or other people say carboxy functional substituted benzene. There are two rings, right? So when these two reactions goes in this solution in the presence of metal like sodium or lithium in presence of tertiary butanol in liquid ammonia that leads to the formation of two different kind of products this is the ortho-meta product and that is going to be formed para product, right? This is the ipso that first carbon, jo first carbon hai jahan pe functional group attached hai, that is called the ipso carbon. So it is going to give you the ipso para product. This is the ortho meta product adjacent to this substituent, and adjacent to this carboxy substituent is going to be ipso para product. Another important point is that this is the methoxy electron donating group, this is the carboxy electron withdrawing group. Similarly, this reaction can also be done in the presence of alkynes. If you treat alkyne with sodium in liquid ammonia, it is going to form transalkene product. It is going to form transalkene product, right? Free electrons in liquid ammonia. It is a blue color solution. Blue solution from alkali metals dissolved in liquid ammonia are said to contain free electrons. Free electrons. ठीक है? And actually free, but it is solvated electron. Metal anion, alkalite, sodium, right? Free, having free electrons. And electrolyte consists of complex alkali metal cation with a trapped electron like Na, NH3, whole 6 electron. This is the complex one, or this is the free electron. So electrolytes and alkalite anion both contribute to lead to the formation of a blue color solution. And that blue color solution is actually responsible for this reaction. So it is a kind of radical anion type of reaction. The mechanism involves initial formation of what? Radical anion by electron introduction from blue free electron solution in liquid ammonia. So for example, benzene when treated with the lithium metal in liquid ammonia, first it takes electron to form first one radical anion. Radical anion. Now this anion then takes proton, because ethanol we have dal rakha hai, it takes proton from the medium to form another radical. Now this radical again takes electron from this metal to form anion. Okay, this is pentacyclopentadiene anion. Okay, kitna 1 2 3 4 5, right? This is the resonance hybrid structure of second one, 1 2 3 4 5, cyclopentadienyl anion, right? Now these two has two different aspects. When it is, this anion is generated at the para position, it reacts with the proton from the medium, leading to the formation of this kind of ipso para product, right? This is, however, this ring is unsubstituted one. It is simply leading to the formation of cyclohexadiene, isolated cyclohexadiene. You see this one, that product, it is going to be the major one. While this conjugated one, it can also takes half proton from the medium to lead to the formation of this conjugated cyclohexadiene product. But this one is going to be the minor product. That one is a point of discussion, why this is going to be the major one and why this is going to be the minor one out of these two products. It has been suggested that electron donor substituents like methoxy or methyl, the dihydroaromatic is formed with the maximum number of substituent on the residual double bonds. Okay? While when it has electron withdrawing group, there is a reverse. There is a reverse. So for example, if it has electron donatory group like methoxy or methyl, then what will happen? Maximum number of substituents on the residual double bond. On the residual double bond. That's why it ultimately leads to the formation of what? Ortho meta product. So first it is going to form the radical anion, right? Two radical anions. Then this third one is the second one. This is the first, this is the second. That is going first form radical anion, then it takes proton to form third species, that is going to be radical. This again takes electron from the medium to generate fourth species, and this is going to behave as a anion, carbon ion. Okay, na? And again takes a proton from the medium, leading to the formation of your product. leading to the formation of your product, right? So ultimately, with respect to this substituent, it is going to be ortho, and with respect to this substituent is meta. So when a benzene ring contains electron donating group as a substituent, under this reduction, Birch reduction, it leads to the formation of a ortho meta derivative, right? However, there is an exception. If this is the NN dimethyl amine, when this molecule is subjected to Birch reduction, it leads to the formation of NN dimethyl substituted cyclohexadiene system, in which the electrons are, in which these two electrons are in the conjugated one, in the conjugated one. Okay, na? This position is totally, this is because of the isomerization that takes place during the course of reaction. That is going to take place in the course of reaction. But in general, in case of methoxy or methyl substituted one, that only leads to the formation of this kind of product, right? That is the going to be the major product. The reaction reaches selectivity with electron donating group, like in case of methoxy, that is all. No para and ipso product is formed. No para and ipso protonation takes place, right? Mechanism is what? Overall mechanism that has been again explained. So first there is a formation of radical anion, then formation of, this is for the formation of ortho product, radical. It takes electron from the medium, again going to form the anion. Then it leads to it takes the proton from the medium, leading to the formation of ortho meta product, right? However, you may discuss ki sir idhar hi kyun ban raha, idhar kyun nahi ban raha. So there may be a resonance. It may initiate in that manner orientation also, in which this negative charge is on the meta position. Then it leads to the formation of this kind of first radical. Then it is going to take the electron from the medium. Then it is going to form the anion. Then again takes proton. Then ultimately the product is going to be the same product, right? But this para position product is not going to be observed. This product we are not going to isolate during the course of reaction. The Birch suggested that first protonation takes place at the meta position. However, Zimmermann suggested that in case of anisole, radical anion form which has highest electron density at the ortho to the methoxy function. So the mechanism of ortho is energetically preferred. So either according to Birch, this reaction may be initiated from this meta position, right? And according to the Zimmermann, this reaction may is initiated from the ortho position. But the overall net result is what? Leading to the formation of ortho meta protonated products. So aap dono mein se koi bhi mechanism chala sakte ho, both the mechanism is going to be the same. So there are some evidences has been given regarding this mechanism. Knowing that radical anions are considerably less basic than the corresponding carbon ions, and thus the protonation will be less exothermic and more selective. It means radical ion protonation will accumulate much less if you run this reaction in the presence of butanol. Mein run karte na. In case of butanol, if you take deuterated butanol, then you will have what? At this ortho and meta position, it is going to have deuterium instead of hydrogen, right? It is going to have deuterium. Okay, na? So that has been explained that protonation will be less exothermic and more selective. It means radical ion protonation will accumulate much less deuterium. Much less deuterium. When the anisole reduction was performed at minus 78 degree with sodium and liquid ammonia and tertiary butyl alcohol containing 2% deuterium, the ratio of meta to ortho deuterium content, the ratio of meta to ortho deuterium content in 2,5-dihydroxyanisole produced was determined and was found that most of the deuterium appeared in the meta position. Most of the deuterium appeared into the meta position. This is the deuterium of meta position. This is the deuterium of the metaposition, and this is the deuterium of the orthoposition, and this is the deuterium of the orthoposition. Okay? If you compare this ratio, it is going to be 7:9 or 7:2, or overall you can say that it is around 7:1. That means first protonation takes place at what? Metaposition, as suggested by the Birch. ठीक है ना? तो आपको प्रोडक्ट मिलेगा ऑर्थो मेटा ही मिलेगा. बट व्हाट विल हैपन? द एक्सटेंट ऑफ प्रोटोनेशन इज मोर फॉर जो फर्स्ट प्रोटोनेशन है दैट इज गोइंग टू अकर एट द मेटा पोजिशन एंड देन एट द ऑर्थो पोजिशन. So the first mechanism which is proposed by the Bird, that is the first, this one, it is leading to the formation of meta, in that means basically both the paths are correct, but if you that evidence on the basis of that evidence, first protonation takes place at the meta position and then ultimately at the ortho position, leading to the formation of dihydrogenated methoxy derivative. This is the evidence in which it has been suggested that ratio of meta to ortho deuterium content was determined and was found that most of the deuterium appeared at the meta position. ठीक है ना? It signifies that selective radical ion protonation occurs at ortho position site with hydrogen. And in case of anisole mechanism, was established by parallel examples. We carried out, if you carry out this reaction with the 1,3-dimethoxybenzene and with 3-methoxytoluene, as shown in this two examples. Okay? So that is going to give you the ratio that also supports the protonation first at the meta position. Now, regio selective with the electron withdrawing group. When the engineering has electron withdrawing groups, right? For example, you see in case of benzoic acid, this regio selectivity is for ipso para position. That means 1,4 protonation. The carbon which is attached with a functional group, that is called the ipso carbon, and opposite to that one, that is the para carbon. Okay, so when the benzene has electron withdrawing group, okay, it leads to the formation of ipso. The regio selectivity for this reaction is what? 1,4, where the formation of radical anion. Mechanism will be same as in case of the ortho beta product. ठीक है, एग्जाम में थोड़ा ध्यान रखिएगा कि बेंजीन रिंग पे सब्स्टिट्यूएंट कौन सा लगा है, इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेटिंग लगा है या इलेक्ट्रॉन विथड्रॉइंग लगा हुआ है. ठीक है ना? यू सी, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल इप्सो मैकेनिज्म फॉर दिस रिएक्शन. सो इट इज फर्स्ट टेक्स इलेक्ट्रॉन, राइट? दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन टेक्स टू फर्स्ट जनरेट द रेडिकल. This radical again takes an electron to form the anion. This anion takes proton from the medium to first protonate that para position. Because जो ortho position है, sorry, जो ipso position है, यहाँ पे जब electron बनेगा, negative charge बनेगा, that will be delocalized with the between the two oxygen atom of the carboxyl function. यहाँ पे delocalized हो जाएगा. So first there is will be what? Because of this resonating structures, electron density will reside more at the para position. ठीक है ना? That is the this para position. So first there is generation of anion at this para position that takes up to take the proton to get protonated. Then again there is a formation of this electron will come back, right? This electron will come back. And that will takes proton from the medium, leading to the formation of your ipso para product. So on carbon, you see the intermediate number 3 revealed that the site of highest electron density in the ring is para to the original carboxyl and greater than the ipso. and thus in accordingly with the para protonation. The first protonation takes place at the para position, leading to the protonation at the ipso position, leading to the formation of the ipso para derivative. Ipso para derivative. These are the data that shows the electron density. इसको आप ना भी पढ़ें तो उसमें कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है, ठीक है? That shows the extent of electron density at the different carbon during the course of reaction. So final step is that, or simply the anion is going to take this proton from the medium, leading formation of this. This is for your information. ये जितना भी content additional content है, ये आप additional पढ़ने के लिए, आपके लिए समझने के लिए. तो वो आप पूरा पढ़िएगा to show that one. But in general, what will happen? When there is a electron donating group, then there is a protonation at the ortho meta position, ठीक है ना? And in which the meta is more labile first for protonation than the ortho position. But when benzene have electron withdrawing group like carboxy group, then the protonation is 1,4 protonation, or another way you can say the regional selectivity is a ipso para protonation. And if you see the resonating structure and in terms of electron density, since the electron density is more at the para position, so first position protonation takes place at the para position and then at the ipso position. ठीक है ना? तो ये दो different states हैं कि जब benzene ring पे electron donating group मौजूद है और जब benzene ring पे electron withdrawing group है, तो दोनों के केस में two different products is going to be form in the Wilk reduction. Okay, that is a small reaction. Now another very very small reaction, बहुत simple सा reaction, एक और छोटा सा है, मिसुनो में नहीं, वो तो बड़ा reaction है. That is the dienone phenol rearrangement. Dienone phenol rearrangement, right? This is an example of generation of the electron deficient carbon. You can say like that one. This mechanism is what, in which the 4,4 substituted cyclohexadienone. This is the 4,4 di substituted cyclohexadienone under acidic condition or under under the photochemical reaction condition. It may undergo rearrangement reactions to form di substituted phenol. In which the substituent present at the fourth position moves from this position to the adjacent carbon. So this is the overall reaction, okay? That is going to form the product. A similar arrangement is also possible with 2,2 disubstituted. This is the 4,4 disubstituted 4,4 disubstituted cyclohexadienone. This is the 2,2 substituted cyclohexadienone. That also leads to the formation of these two kinds of product. The rearrangement is spontaneous, okay? Unless the presence of dichloromethyl group at third position or fourth position is blocked. अगर आपका third position, right, or fourth position block होगा, तब ये rearrangement reaction block हो जाएगा, नहीं चलेगा आगे. The migration tendency of two different groups are present at either fourth pole position or 2,2 position can be determined by comparing the relative stability of your intermediate carbocation, which is formed during the course of rearrangement. So let us discuss the complete mechanism. So first, under the acidic condition, dienone, this own functional, first gets protonated to form the oxonium. Now with the movement of this electron, right, this electron is going to move. So it is going to create plus center here. This plus center is going to be created. Once this plus center is created, the electron deficient carbon, and its neighbor is the alkyl group, or this R may be either simple methyl group or maybe phenyl group. So agar do different ग्रुप्स हैं तो उसपे जो ज्यादा इफेक्ट डालेगा प्लस चार्ज को इन्फ्लुएंस करने में वो माइग्रेट करेगा. बट सपोज इन जनरल इट इज ए टू एल्किल ग्रुप, सो वन ऑफ द एल्किल ग्रुप इज गोइंग टू माइग्रेट बाय द 1,2 शिफ्ट. दिस एल्काइल ग्रुप मूव्स फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस पोजीशन एंड देन देयर इज एरोमेटाइजेशन लीडिंग टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फिनॉल प्रोडक्ट. दैट इज द अल्टीमेटली व्हाट विल हैपन. 1,2,3 3,4-dialkyl phenol is going to form, right? This is a general mechanism for the dinone phenol, okay? And that leads to the formation of a phenol product, okay? In case of specific compounds, rearrangements occurs in two different ways. As for example, you see this one. This is a bicyclic compound. So again, this is a dienone system. Under acidic condition, it may have this kind of movement, or it may have another kind of movement, right? So suppose when this red one movement of electron going to start, the first is going to form hydroxy derivative, right? Then plus center is going to created at this ring, correct? This ring, whenever there is a plus center adjacent to a ring, that means it may proceed for ring contraction. So this electron, this sigma bond, right, is going to migrate. That means this 6-membered ring is going to become 5-membered ring. You see this one. This 5-membered ring, right? This 5-membered ring is going to form. Now it has plus center here. So again, there is a delocalization of electron. You see this electron is going to move. Then this electron is going to move. So now this plus center is going to be created. So whenever plus charge is present adjacent to a ring, that is on the other ring, then there is a possibility of ring expansion. So again, yeah, first kya hua? First ring contraction hua, and then ye iske neighboring carbon pe, adjacent carbon pe second ring mein hai, so it is going to be expanded again. So this 5-membered ring again becoming 6-membered ring, and ultimately what will happen? So this electron will, so this 5-membered ring become 6-membered ring with the release of proton. So one of the ring is going to aromatize, another one is simple aliphatic ring, simple cyclohexene type of system. But overall result will be what? You see that this one changes into the 6 via the root red one, this red one, in which first there is a ring contraction, then there is a ring expansion, ultimately leading to the formation of this bicyclic product, in which one of the ring is aromatic, leading to the formation of, you see that there is a migration of group. A group aapko migrate karta hua dikhai padega, but that has happened because of the ring contraction as well as ring expansion. So you are going to get this hydroxy product from this cyclohexadienone. Now, adopting the second path, if you adopt the second path, blue one, this blue one, now see, this electron is going to move. So what will happen? At this position, it is going to, this carbon is going to be the electron deficient. This position, electron deficiency. So what will happen? Simply, this methyl group, which is present adjacent to this electron deficient carbon, this is going to migrate. So there is again 1-2 shift of the alkyl group that leads to the formation of another type, another product. That is the, it is again ek product yahan pe mila hua hai aapko jisme the substituents kya hai benzenic pe 1,4 hai, 1,4 methyl and hydroxy. But if you adopt the second path, then because of the migration of this methyl group, it leads to the formation of third intermediate that will aromatize with the release of proton to form the final product, that is the fourth one. So it means what? This simple cyclohexadienone, this is a bicyclic compound, it may adopt two paths, in which one is methyl migration is going to take place, leading to the formation of this 1,3 substituted bicyclic product. But if it is going to take the another path, this is the red arrow path, then there is involvement of the ring contraction followed by the ring expansion, leading to the formation of 1,4 substituted bicyclic ring. So that is the importance and importance of this bicyclic system, which involves dienone phenol reaction leading to the formation of two isomeric products. Do isomeric products aapke banenge. This is the evidence which shows if you ठीक है ना, इफ यू लेबल दिस कार्बन, विल सी दिस कार्बन हैज बीन लेबल्ड. स्टार मींस क्या है, ये कार्बन लेबल्ड किया है. तो इट क्लियरली इंडिकेट्स द इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द रिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड रिंग एक्सपेंशन लीडिंग टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. तो इट मींस डायनोफिनॉल अरेंजमेंट ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व्स इन केस ऑफ बाइसाइक्लिक कंपाउंड्स ओनली, इट इन्वॉल्व्स रिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एज वेल एज रिंग एक्सपेंशन. ठीक है ना. So that is all about your dienol-phenol rearrangement reaction. बहुत छोटा सा reaction था, इसलिए मैंने इसको same thing. ठीक है. So today we have discussed two reactions, that is the work reduction and dienol-phenol rearrangement reaction. So in the next term we will discuss two more reactions. ठीक है ना. समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं? एनीवन?
आ रहा है सर.
हाँ ठीक. तो आज के लिए बस इतना ही, बस बहुत है. ठीक है. सो यू मे लीव द मीटिंग, नेक्स्ट मंडे वी विल मीट. ओके ओके.
सर प्लीज शेयर द प्रेजेंट पीपीटीज.
शेयर द पीपीटीज अगेन. अच्छा ईमेल्स है ना?
यस सर.
हाँ हाँ मैं भेजूंगा. ठीक है मैं भेज दूंगा. आज शाम को भेजूंगा या कल भेज दूंगा डेफिनेटली. ओके
ठीक है सर. थैंक यू.
डोंट वरी आई विल शेयर. डोंट वरी. ओके जस्ट लीव द कॉल.